The mayor of Glan in Sarangani vows support for those affected by the powerful tremors that hit the municipality. Last week, southern Mindanao's quake was followed by a magnitude 4.9 tremor in Sarangani Tuesday. At least five people have died there, while 85 others were injured. Glan has already been placed under a state of calamity.
We are very busy giving relief goods to the affected families, and nagbibigay po din yung DSWD ng assistance for those partially and totally damaged houses. Because in all, partially and totally damaged houses nasa 2,300.
And we've been following the story very closely. Transport Group Piston holding a demonstration in Mindanao on day three of its nationwide transport strike. Meanwhile, another transport group, Manibela, kicks off its own protest action over government's PUV modernization program. Our very own Jackie Manabat joins us with details. Jackie, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, the transport strike will continue for a full work week after another driver's group decided to continue the protests until Friday. The transport strikes of two groups, Piston and Manibela, coincided today, Wednesday. Piston marched this morning from Welcome Rotonda in Quezon City to Mendiola Street in Manila, or the road leading to Malacañang, and they merged with other members who came from different areas of Metro Manila. On the other hand, Manibela started their protest rally at the University of Philippines in Quezon City and made a brief stop in front of LTFRB in Quezon City. Then the both transport groups, Manibela and Piston, they eventually merged with some Piston members in Mendiola, almost crowding the intersection. However, according to Piston, another protest will occur in the coming weeks. Piston President Modi Floranda said that the protest may also come in other forms. Now, the protests will continue until LTFRB yields to their request, which is to scrap the consolidation requirements under the PUV modernization project, or to postpone the year-end deadline for the said consolidation. The strike continued despite the dialogue with LTFRB Chairman Chufilo Guadis last Monday. That's the first day of Piston's transport strike. Piston said that while they acknowledged that some of their demands were given consideration by LTFRB, but the most crucial request was not met, which is to scrap the consolidation requirement under the PUV modernization program. Piston said that the consolidation process benefits them only if it takes away their rights, particularly those single-unit operators to own a franchise. LTFRB explained earlier that the consolidation would help them take out loans from the bank for the modernization project and monitor the jeepney units. This discussion on the consolidation process seems to have reached an impasse, because LTFRB already said that this part of the modernization project is non-negotiable. However, LTFRB said they're not giving up hope, as they are opening their office to discuss this disagreement. The public will be, what we are sure right now is that the public will be experiencing impacts of transport strikes until Friday, but the government assures the public that they would deploy free ride assistance and would help manage the traffic flow.
Fewer Filipinos consider themselves as poor. A survey by the Okta Research Group shows 46%, or around 12.1 million Filipinos, rated themselves poor in the third quarter of this year. This is lower than the July figure of 13.2 million Filipinos. The survey also recorded a decrease in self-rated hunger. Around 10%, or an estimated 2.6 million families, experienced involuntary hunger in the July to September period. This is lower than the second quarter data of 15%, or 3.9 million hungry families. The Philippine Agriculture Chief gives rice importers 30 days to use their import permits or lose them. The DA secretary issued the deadline as prices of the staple grain begin to spike in Metro Manila. Jervis Manahan reports.
In a congressional hearing on Monday, Agriculture Secretary Francisco T. Laurel Jr. warned rice importers that their import clearances will be forfeited if their approved volume will not reach the country in 30 days. He said there's 1 million metric tons of rice that's valid to enter the country.
Sabi ko sa kanila, pag hindi nyo import yan within 30 days, hindi kayo mabigyan ng PO, kakancelin ko lahat yan. Because I don't want to be held hostage by, you know, permits that were issued to them upon their request. Diba? So, then yun, wala rin ho akong alam na nagsiset ngayon kung ano dapat ang import volumes.
This comes amidst rising price of rice in most markets in Metro Manila. In Commonwealth Market, rice is being sold at 56 pesos per kilo. The high price alarmed Rice Watch Group Bantay Bigas.
Ito ay napakalayo dun sa binanggit ng Department of Agriculture na dapat ay 48 lang ang presyo ng regular milled rice.
The group belied allegations that the spike is due to high price of palay or unhusked rice. Bantay Bigas asserts the price of rice is still very low in many provinces.
Yung monitoring mismo ng Bantay Bigas ay meron pa ng 15.50 centavos sa albay, presyo ng bagong ani. Ganun sa Mindoro at saka mismo dito sa Laguna ay nananatiling mababa, 20 pesos per kilo.
The Department of Agriculture assured lawmakers on Monday that supply of rice is stable. They said the buffer stock is enough to last until the first quarter of 2024. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
Prices of over 150 products commonly used during Christmas Eve celebrations in the Philippines have risen. These items include ham, fruit cocktail, mayonnaise, among others. Prices of some Noche Buena items have been rising as early as October. The cost of ham has gone up by 6 pesos per pack, while elbow macaroni has seen an uptick of around 7 pesos. The Philippine Central Bank advises the public to be vigilant against counterfeiters this holiday season. Alvin El Chico tells us how to spot fake money in this report.
Cashier Nori makes it a habit to scrutinize 1,000 peso bills paid by customers. If a counterfeit bill slips into the store, the cashier in charge will have to pay for it.
Charge po sa amin yon. At the same time, lalo na po ngayong December, talagang marami talagang lumalabas na mga ganyang pera. Kaya kailangan doble ingat po kami. Dito po sa parang flower niya, meron kang makikitang BSP. Tapos dito naman po sa taas, yun, parang meron siyang may makakapaka. Tsaka yung isa din sa chine-check namin, eto po. Apo, dito sir, yung kailangan hindi faded po yung print sa loob.
Supermarket owners appeal to consumers to understand cashiers if they take their time in checking the money, especially the 1,000 peso bill.
Pasensya na ang public kapag dine-check natin. Dahil syempre, sino mag gusto makatanggap ng kahit kayo bilang mamimili? Ayaw kayo makatanggap ng binayaran kayo, supplier kayo, binayaran kayo ng fake. Hindi na magagamit.
Ordinary Filipinos have various ways to make sure the money they have are authentic.
Yung tao, masinisim, yung sinisipat pag merong nakikita. Tsaka yung sa yung pangalan po nung 1,000.
Pag malapis siya, tsaka pag kumukupas po siya, yung pag binasa mo siya, kumukupas po talaga. Kasi nasubukan ko na po yun. Pag yung, lalo na pag 1,000.
Yung kulay ko minsan, parang blurred siya. Oh, mahalo siya. Yung pera natin medyo matingkad.
The Banco Central ng Pilipinas clarifies there is no official complaint regarding counterfeit 1,000 peso polymer notes. But as the holiday season nears, the BSP has issued some guidance to the public regarding the new 1,000 peso bill. The sampaguita-shaped clear window on the left side of the bill is pronounced, while the supposed fake one has a clear shape. One can feel the transparent embossed line structures with the text BSP inside the flower. On the supposed fake notes, the transparent vertical window has a different shape. One can also feel the 5 highly embossed dots intended to assist the elderly and visually impaired.
Tama po ang ginagawa na pagsilip-silip kasi po ang ating method or paraan ng pag-detect ng kahit anong pera, mapapel, ma-plastic, or polymer ay ang tinatawag na feel, look, tilt.
The BSP has again reiterated that the new bills can be folded.
As long as wag talaga nating sasadyain or intentional nating lulukutin. Kasi po yon ay nakakasira.
But what happens if you obtain a counterfeit money?
Ang procedure is we have to confiscate the money and then we send it to Banco Central. So that's the policy. Pinipilit natin kasi maraming maraming madadamay eh. So masi-circulate yung money, eh, hindi mo ibibigay, tapos matatransfer lang sa to other persons.
Experts claim, if one surrenders the fake money to the bank, there is no criminal liability, but the counterfeit bill will not be replaced with a real one. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.
Students in public schools might soon find their Fridays dedicated to enhanced learning. The Department of Education is introducing a Catch Up Fridays program, which aims to help students read and comprehend better. The details from Joyce Balancho.
The Department of Education, or DepEd, will soon order schools to designate Friday of every week as a day for students to catch up on their learning, particularly on reading, values education, health, and peace education. Vice President and Education Secretary Sara Duterte says Catch Up Fridays will begin on January 12, 2024. Subjects initially scheduled during Fridays will be included in the first 4 days of the week to give way to this new schedule. DepEd will release on December the guidelines for the implementation.
So ito yung strategy natin sa paghahabol sa part ng ating learning recovery program, dahil nakita natin na ginagawa naman natin lahat noon pero hindi pa rin nag-i-improve ang performance ng ating mga learners, particularly sa international assessments.
The Education Secretary cited a recent study by the World Bank which found that learning poverty in the Philippines was at 91% in 2022, which meant 9 out of 10 Filipino children aged 10 still struggled to read simple texts.
Nakikita natin na hindi talaga maganda yung kalidad ng edukasyon. At sisimulan talaga natin dapat na matuto ang mga bata magbasa. And marami talaga tayong mga non-readers at saka marami tayong mga slow readers. Kaya kailangan silang lahat bigyan ng isang araw na wala silang gagawin kundi mag-practice at matuto magbasa. Even yung mga magagaling na natin na magbasa, dapat i-level up yung kanilang reading skills.
Some parents expressed support for the new DepEd program.
Sa amin kasi mas okay kung sa teacher kasi kami kasi may mga trabaho din kami. Minsan hindi namin maasikaso yung mga bata. Parehas kami mag-asawa, may trabaho eh.
Medyo ginagalamay pa niya yung mga pagbabasa. Pero syempre, pag tumagal naman din niya matutukan, matututunan din niya magbasa.
On Tuesday morning, Duterte also led the culmination of the National Reading Month celebration. The DepEd has initiated programs to promote reading among students, including the establishment of reading pantries in schools, as well as activities such as share a book drive and book buddy sessions. Duterte concluded the activities with the launch of the children's book Isang Kaibigan, which she personally wrote for young learners.
Merong isang ibon at marami siyang kaibigan. Merong nangyaring unos sa buhay niya at nawala lahat ng mga kaibigan niya. Akala niya nawala lahat, pero merong isa na bumalik at tumulong sa kanya. At yun yung lesson doon sa libro, yung friendship and kindness.
In her speech during the event, Duterte stressed the importance of reading among young learners and how this foundational skill would support them as they achieve their goals.
Mamagitan ng pagbabasa, maaari kayong mamuhay sa mundo kung saan makakayanan ninyong abutin ang inyong mga pangarap. Ang pagbabasa ang susi na magbubukas ng mga kahangahangang bagay para sa bawat isa sa inyo.
She also urges parents to encourage their children to find interest in reading, the same way she was taught by her mother. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.